reconciled to your brother, and then come and offer your gift. Make friends quickly with your accuser. While you are going with him to court, let your accuser hand you over to the judge, or the judge to the guard, and you be put in prison. Truly, I say to you, you will never get out till you have paid the last penny. The Gospel of
God. Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
As you know, I am learning how to serve. It's taking time. But I can now, sort of, with lots of help from Matthew, the instructor, get to sitting on my knees on the board. That's a great try for me. I have a problem getting my foot around to bench to stand on the board, but that's another story for another day. However, I was doing marvelously well with my knees on the board, and I looked up and happened to see two people in the wrong position. And I quickly deduced that they were younger than me, so it would heal more quickly than me. So, gliding into them softly would probably not be too much of a problem. And I also thought that, you know, I might just be able to stand and, you know, do what they do on TV, glide past. None of that happened. I crashed into one of them. They apologized, but it was right, because they'd been in my way. But they would have been something of a drop in. Apparently, the surf has the right of way, so if you see me surfing towards you, be careful. But how often have we dropped in on behalf of another person's journey towards holiness? How often have we said something or judged somebody or just been a little offish? When a person was really trying to do the right thing, because most of us, in my experience, are trying to do the right thing in our lives. We're trying to ride the wave as best we can. As much as we may irritate or get in the way of other people, we are at least, I believe, this is human nature, we have this instinctive thing to try and do the right thing. And so, if we take for granted that everybody is at least trying to do the right thing, even though I might not understand or approve of the way they're doing it, when I destroy their attempt, I'm the drop in. I'm destroying whatever they may need to continue to try and ride the way of God's love that they are trying to. And I love this scripture today because he talks about problems. And he specifically talks about you and I. Because I found that the holier I feel on one day, the next day I realized I'm actually not so holy at all. I was in this kind of illusion. So we can come to Mass and we can feel that what we're doing is wonderful and just, and that it is enough. But the scripture says today, no. It is a curious thing. He says, bring your gift and leave it at the altar. Go, reconcile, and then come back, pick up that gift, and present it. So it's offering it, but it's not presenting it to God. So it means that God is saying, I can see your gift, but you are not worthy. like I explained in the story, I was popping out by saying, well, I'm just hit into them because they're younger than me. That's a cop out. Or I could have simply got off the board. I was in shallow water, nobody would be harmed. But I decided to go for it because my own ego of wanting to have another attempt to stand on this board was more important than crashing into something. How often have we done that in our spiritual lives? We've come in our own egos that have said, this is more important than another person's